So before I came into medical school, I had an opportunity to teach seventh grade science. And it was really there that I realized that medicine encompasses more than just what takes place in the doctor's office. And when I got into medical school, the Northwest campus encouraged us to, you know, engage the community. And I found POP, an anti-violence foundation. I saw that they were making an impact in the needs that my students had. And I was very excited to be able to continue impacting that community that I was teaching by now being a medical student and not having to wait until I was a doctor before I could do anything. I feel like the scholarly concentration is helping me see what it means to be a physician to an urban community, because you can't just stay in the hospital. You have to get into the community and see what the community's needs are. And that's what this scholarly concentration is all about, meeting the needs of the community.
I really want to go into neurology, so I really wanted to be able to explore a field that I love, and I made a partnership with the local hospital system here, and specifically for the scholarly concentration, I focused on stroke prevention. We went ahead and had a big stroke fair in an underserved community, and there we just kind of wanted to talk to the residents. What do they know about stroke prevention? What do they know about stroke treatment? So by doing a community needs assessment, engaging what the community needs, we can further address those gaps in stroke knowledge and further kind of drive how we're going to do this stroke outreach initiative. This opportunity is important to me, and it means a lot to me because it embodies everything that I could ever dream of. So it essentially allows me to practice in the and get experience in the field that I eventually want to go into. It allows me to build relationships with the community members and to give back to the community that I grew up in. And it also allows me to gain experience that we don't necessarily gain here in the classroom. And those three things are something I'm thankful for every day here in Gary.
You know, as medical students, we sort of have the tendency to just bury ourselves in our books, and then we're just here all hours of the day and night. But really, there's a whole, you know, world and community going outside. And in a few years, we're literally going to be out there working on the front lines, you know, trying to help people and you know, be their doctors. So being able to be out in the community, working with the community organization I work with, POP on Youth Violence, I like to go out and you know, be a part of events, try and reduce some of these problems that we see going on that we're very aware of. And if we achieve that, and I believe, you know, in some part we are actively doing that, what we'll begin to see is we'll begin to see a reduction in some of these serious health problems. We'll begin to see a reduction in the case of my project in youth violence. I mean, really, in those cases, it's a lot of times loss of life at a very young age. From the health perspective, that's devastating. This person essentially should be alive, except for the choices of maybe themselves or the choices of other people around them. So being able to give someone the rest of their life, essentially, it's a really profound and a really important goal that we strive for.